Hey guys, Katie here from Dreamview Puppies, and today's gonna be a little bit of a different video. I ended up with a newborn orphaned puppy. I got a call from a friend that knew of this puppy and knew that she had to get involved to find an alternative situation for it, or it would likely not thrive and survive. So. The hope was that when I first picked him up, that he would be reunified. Yes, with mom. I'm running a little sleep because it's like having a newborn baby. When I got him on Friday, today's Monday, when I got him on Friday, mom was really sick with a uterine infection. It was an unplanned breeding, didn't know she was pregnant. I believe maybe there was other puppies that didn't survive. I'm not quite sure the whole story, but he is the one and only puppy from the litter. And I thought, well, if I could take this puppy for the weekend, maybe that would give mom time to heal, the antibiotics a chance to work. But unfortunately, she did end up passing away later that day. So I have had him. He's been going everywhere I go in my little handy dandy incubator here. I'll show it to you. Had a sign on it so nobody would touch it, but I have this incubator that I got from My Breeder Supply, and it has like a heater and it's plugged in, and it's got an air vent and different things, so it's keeping him warm. I have been having to tube feed because he is so small and it takes forever to bottle feed him. He doesn't do well with it, so instead of spending, you know, 25 minutes trying to get this puppy to eat, I have switched to tube feeding him, and it goes much quicker. So he's steady, he's strong, he's stable. So I'm happy about that. But my hope is to find a mom dog of similar size to the breed, with similar age puppies to hopefully integrate him into. Because this is supposed to be our break, but I can't say no when I know that if I don't take it on, it likely won't survive. So here I am. It's a little Shih Tzu Yorkie mix, and I named him Chance, just so I have something to call him, hoping that we are giving him a second chance at life here. So let me introduce you to the little fella. Hopefully he's clean. Oh my, he must have had some major poop. He's kind of messy, which I'm gonna consider poop good because it means he's eating and everything, but he's kind of gross right now. You get a good weight on him. He's been staying pretty stable and not really gaining or losing, which I would love to see him gain, but You can see he's quite strong and has the energy. 10 ounces, 10.8 ounces. Oh, and now we're peeing. So I've just been like working with him, stimulating him using the bathroom. I have to do this when they're this young because it mimics like what mom would do by licking, and it helps stimulate them to go to the bathroom. He is a week and a day old. He was born on the 15th. Today is the 23rd. Look at that face. I don't mind the messiness. I gotta clean him up, but I am going to show you how I tube feed. So I have a 12 milliliter syringe here, which we're about outgrown, but I'm gonna use it today, and a small red feeding tube. I pretty much just measure out the length of him from his mouth to his stomach area, And that's about how long I mark a little black dot with a Sharpie on here to kind of give me an idea how far in it needs to be. And so then I work this tube into his mouth. And I just keep feeding it in until it gets to be about the length I want. And then I kind of hold it there to the side so he's not gagging on it. And as long as I can't pull any air out, I know it's not going into his lungs. And you want 1 cc or milliliter per his ounce in weight. And I don't go too fast, I just, you gotta stop touching that, buddy. I can't keep it in like that. And I just kind of slowly plunge it in. You wanna make sure that it's not in their airway instead of their stomach. So that's why, as long as they're breathing and grunting while you're feeding them, that's good, because you know it's where it belongs. Almost done. That's that. You just simply pull it out. And he's got a nice, fat, full belly. And I'm actually going to go try to wash him up a little bit with some warm water and get him clean and dry here. But, yeah, stay tuned for what happens with little man here. He's so cute and sweet. I'm giving him the best chance I can here. So I got him all washed up. I just make sure he's good and dry. Because one of the ways that a newborn can incline quickly is if it is not being kept warm. So I am also going to give him, because he's not really gaining weight. He's beautiful, isn't he? He's not really gaining weight. So I'm going to give him a little bit of, where is it? It's in my bag here. This Nature Mate. It's by Breeder's Edge, and it's like a colostrum supplement, so just help give him some extra calories. He's not feeling dehydrated at this point, so that's good. Something I'm keeping an eye on. Oh, he sounds like a chipmunk, doesn't he? So cute. Now that I fed you, let's see where you're at. Oh my goodness. I know. It's like not even an ounce I've added to you. All right. All right. So we're just gonna try to get a little bit extra nutrients in him here. Put a little bit on my, I'm going to sanitize again. Where do you think you're going, honey? You gotta get some more food in you. So I'm just putting this in his mouth. Hoping he'll get, swallow some of it and get some of that extra in his system here. He does have a suckle reflex, but he does not do well with the bottle. So I'm just trying to give him a little bit extra. Look at that face, seriously. Sounds like a chipmunk. You sound like a little chippy. Like a little chipmunk. You're probably cold. Let's keep you wrapped up and dry. I clean out your messy little box here. He made quite the mess. I'm gonna clean him up and tuck him back in, and I'll be back in to feed him again in 3 hours. Isn't he sweet? If you know of anybody that would want to add him to a litter. I'm getting too old for this being up every 3 hours business.
All right, well, update. It is the evening of the same day, and I was able to find a Yorkie litter that's local and raised to my standards, that we were able to drop Chance off, and we are praying he does well. They're going to keep a close eye. But yeah, I'm feeling really hopeful that this will be a really good thing for him. I just think, as much as I love him and would, you know, work hard to take care of him, it's not the same as having litter mates and a mama to kind of show you the way and nurture. So I'm really hopeful and excited. So prayers, please, that this works out well. And if not, he will be back tomorrow. but I'm just feeling good about it. So that is the current update, and I will hopefully do an update at some point on how he's doing.
Quick little update. It's been about a week and a half since I took Chance over to integrate him with this new litter, and he is, his eyes opened up almost immediately after being there, and he started walking before he was even 2 weeks old, which kind of blew our minds. But I wonder if it's more of a survival tactic to start doing those things earlier in this situation. Forgive me, I'm sick, I have stuff there. But just wanted to get this video finished and up for you. But he is doing fabulous. He hit a pound real quick. They're supplementing a couple times a day just so mom doesn't get depleted too quickly and make sure he's getting enough because he is bigger. But yeah, all is going well. I'm so excited he got another chance at life. And yeah, I'll try to put a picture in here of the most recent one that I've got them. Thanks for watching, guys.